I feel like I should put some dinosaurs out.
This is cute, huh?
Okay. Sure.
It actually worked.
Yeah. It worked 23 other times that I did it.
I want to use this incredible facial muscle model to talk about this circular muscle going around the eye called orbicularis oculi. And based on its name, you can tell they named it because it's orbiting the eye. But you can also see from its fiber orientation that it's going to close the eye. And that could be a reflexive close, as in you're blinking, or maybe if sweat's starting to pour down, this muscle can contract and tightly shut and prevent that sweat from getting inside of your eye.
A single piece of coiled DNA is known as a chromosome. Our temperature are Celsius and Fahrenheit equal... I'm gonna go... Oh, yes! Pure water has a pH level of 7. How many bones does a shark have? 0. They're fat. Which satellite has... what is the most abundant gas? Nitrogen. Oh my god!
Tree, plus I got this brown in me. Curly ever dancing on me. Said she smelled the green on me. And she straight from California. Freaky as yeah, she wanna be. Tell me she like boys and girls. Oh well, that's all.
Yeah, let me sing him from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
Soap is an amazing substance. Each soap molecule is like a string, with one end that sticks to water and the other end that sticks to oil or fat. So take a look at this. This string floating on water represents a coronavirus molecule. Watch what happens when we touch the surface of the water with this bar of soap. 3, 2, 1. The molecule falls apart. That's why you've got to wash your hands, wash your hands, wash your hands. Woo! Take that, virus molecule.
In a glass, fill it halfway with water, adding 5 drops of food coloring, a little mix. I'm going to place some of these white Elysiums in here. Leave this in a sunny spot for 24 hours. After this time, you'll notice that the flowers have changed colour. Here's another one I did with red food dye. And this is how it works. Capillary action and transpiration.
Amy, what are you doing? It's 2 a.m.
We need a lava lamp.
A what?
We need more decorations in this apartment anyway.
Is it a lava lamp?
We need a lava lamp.
That's my light.
No. All right, so we're going to...
Oh my, that's so much oil.
Bought a little bit too much oil by this one. All right, so now I need vinegar. I don't know how much I need. I have these leftovers.
So, is there a reaction from this, or is it just
no? Dying? It's just gonna, you know how the bubbles in the lava lamp have color?
Yeah.
So that's what this is, and then I'm gonna add some glitter too.
It's shimmering.
All right, don't get too close, I might splash you.
I think bubbles are floating.
I actually have babies. So this is what's going to make it react.
Whoa! Oh, that is insane.
Oh,
nice.
Oh no, oh no.
Oh, that's the coolest lava lamp
I've ever...
Here's how to turn an egg into a bouncy ball.
all you need is a jar with a lid, raw eggs, white vinegar, and paper towels. First, put the raw eggs in the jar and pour in enough vinegar to cover them. Then screw the lid on and let the jar sit for 1 week. After a week, carefully remove the eggs from the jar and wipe them off with a paper towel. You'll see the vinegar has dissolved the shells of the egg, leaving the inner membranes intact. Give them a drop from a low height and they should bounce.
Hello, I am a high schooler and I do neuroscience research on fruit flies. Last summer I went to Berkeley to do research, but this summer there was a pandemic, so the flies had to come to me. Basically, I had to build a neuroscience lab out of my bathroom, which was, you know, a stressful task. So I started by cleaning literally every inch of my bathroom, and then I organized all of the materials that I would need. After that, I measured a bunch of places to make sure anything I added fit. But you know, my flies needed somewhere to stay, so I built them this cute little shelf in the shower, and then I organized them all on there. Next, I added a desk, and then a chair, and then my microscope and laptop. And here's the mini lab in action. It actually works very well, and I'm looking at the flies under the microscope there. This is what they look like. Very cool, right? So here's the finished product, and it took quite a while to make. So please like this video if you support young scientists. Thanks!